Good morning, Rabbi Isai. Ah, Shalom Aleichem. From Manchester?
Yes.
It's not my birthday. Not my birthday, sorry. Tomorrow, Moti.
My rof is called.
Is this tomorrow?
My rof is called Stefanski. I love Stefanski from Canada.
1 minute, the shit just started. It's not my birthday.
Every day's your birthday. We brought more guys.
Hesbov Kislev, sorry, you messed up. Not accepting it. Not accepting, take it back. Nice try. I bet that, what are you going to slap it in my face? Surprise, not my birthday. You didn't get me. Shkoyach. No, you can take it out of here. Oh, no. Shkoyach. Shvacha Mais is here.
Say thank you.
My name is... No, I'm not saying thank you. It's not a good surprise. On the wrong, I'm not saying thank you. Shkoyach Nachmi, you say
thank you. Thank you, Mati, for what
he did. Thank you, Mati. Yankee Reich, Nayat Anonymous. I live in Lakewood. I tutor in yeshivas. Originally came from Manchester.
Yeah.
You know the guy?
Yeah.
I feel like I'm mamish learning chavrusa with you every day. Hashem give you koyach to get your start at 120. Yankee Reich. This guy has to go this way. Okay, look in the screen. The new guys. Maybe it's not such. Oh, that's right. No, that way. Oh, that's right. You see that screen? Only me. Your face in there? No good. Here, like this. Show him what it looks like. All right, this is Yankee Rapper. Boys, can we start the shir over again? I would have said thank you, but he asked me to say thank you. Whatever he says, I do the opposite. Every time. Yaakov Nussbaum, Baruch Hashem. F217, steiging away while waiting for Tomahawk Steakhouse to open. Whatever that means. Where's Tomahawk Steakhouse? Zvi Klempner from Coral Springs, Florida. Started Sturm Sechta with MDY. And Shmuley Davidowitz. I don't know, his Rosh Hashiva is behind there somewhere. Who's this guy? Another guy. But boys, don't ask me for brachas today. It's not my birthday. Josh Stroke. He's an anonymous rep from North Dallas. This is, but boys, say North Dallas. Up, Josh Anonymous, North Dallas. His North Dallas, but boys, say one more. Chief Sickles, F117, doing the daf. The chief himself. Givaldic. A couple of emails here. David Hendler, I need to tell you thank you. I'll soon be 50 years old and I've only now finished my first Masechta with Rosh Hashanah. All my life I was made to feel like Gemara is something for the other guy and not for a regular person like myself, but you make it feel like Gemara is for everyone. And for that, I pray that Hashem should bless you with all good, etc. I've given away my 2 free Gemaras to bring in some friends, and together we have a small group down here in San Antonio, Texas. Gee, Dallas and San Antonio. We're almost bigger in Texas than we are here in Mavid Shemesh. Unbelievable. Thank you for sharing your passion and knowledge. David Hendler, San Antonio. I got an email from Yitzi Shalevitz and David Goldberg, Mordechai Sapoznik, Yoel Mizrahi sent me a long one. We're not going to read it here. Shlomo Nossen Rotberg says that in Baltimore, there's a Chazar incentive for Rosh Hashanah. So this morning, as he gave, he donated $180. He won $180 in that raffle for the Chazar incentive. You see, Nisim happened, Shmuel.
Sorry?
Shmuel, you're the guy with the, you give a little bit to the daf, you get back, the whole thing. You know the end of the story? His story was published in a Mishpacha. He came back over here, so he got $1,000 more. Because it was published in Mishpacha, many thousands of dollars were sent in after that. It's great. My name is Tully Adler. I really enjoy your shir. It changes the day, so thank you. Regarding the video that you mentioned, two guys shoveling, there's actually a reason for two people shoveling dirt, one onto the truck, one off the truck. Wow. It's two different types of dirt. One is old dirt that has to be removed, and the one coming down is the finer, cleaner sand. See, you can be melamed tzchus on anything you want. What nach? I had an interesting one. This one is for Nach himself. Oh, Mrs. Richards. I wanted to thank you. My 12-year-old son was finding it hard to connect with davening at school, and it was hard for him to get up in the morning. After hearing about Stefanski's shir starting Rosh Hashanah from Rabbi Kornbluth. Who's Rabbi Kornbluth? Oh, the Rav. Oh, the Rome. He's a rabbi?
Yes.
He's still in America?
No.
No, he's back. So after hearing from Rabbi Kornbluth, my husband suggested that he go with my son. My husband said if it lasts a week, it's still a great experience. Fast forward to today, it's my son who gets my husband motivated to get out of bed without missing a single day. My son even made his first siyum, 12 years old. Oh, we have a Chaim Tzvi. That's not him, that's him? This is him? Get over here, Chaim Tzvi. She. Ah, so you're Chaim Tzvi Richards, I had no idea. I was going to call you up anyway. I was supposed to go to your siyum yesterday, but I ended up coming home really late. Shalom Aleichem, Mazel Tov. Chaim Tzvi, Richards, how old are you? This is your first ever Masechta? And you wake your father up? Yeah, keep it up. We're going to finish Shas together. They're truly loving the whole experience that has totally changed our morning routine. It has been an amazing bonding experience for them. Even more, the inspiration they get from Shir stays with them all day. See, changes the wives also. The whole thing, it's a matzah. Today's Shir, sponsored, Masechtas Tainus is dedicated by the Kessel and Davis families, Refuah Shleima for Miriam Esther Bas Devaira, Amen. Parents of Chodesh, Kislev, sponsored by Yoili. Lili Nishmas, his father, sister, and Shver. Parents of Chodesh, Reuven Klein, Muhammad Bas Kolev. The Hannes brothers, in honor of the Hannes Sapsida and Crispin Benazara families, Shlomo Lazarin for inspiring us to join MDY. Lili Nishmas, Menachem Ben Yukusila Koyen. Manny Khan, whose ninth year is today. Shlomo Rosenblum, in honor of the Lubavitcher Rebbe's wedding anniversary. There's no Tachlin today, Rabbi Yisrael in Chabad.
It's a major story.
Major story. And honestly, by a dad, in honor of my 19-year-old, this must be a joke. Nachamal, you hear this? I just hopped now. Anonymously, by a dad, in honor of my 19-year-old, but also to all my five beautiful children. He's probably talking about me, I think. I don't know, unless I thought I was the only guy with five children. I know it's real. It's real, so okay, I know where it's from. We should always know right from wrong and be mistaken, and all they do, love more than they could ever imagine. Shkoya, Isaac Zafir, in honor of Michael Harbader, for joining MDY. Oh, you got one. You know who Isaac Zafir is?
Very good.
Get over here! Come, say Shalom Aleichem to Isaac Zafir. Avi Mandelbaum, in honor of the engagement of my eldest. Come. Daphne Ziffer, we got to start. Fischl's neighbor, Zach Ornstein, Mazel Tov. All right, Rabbi, so here we go. We're going to say Shalom Aleichem to a new guy. Where are you from?
Sorek.
Where were you all these years?
Farakway,
okay. I meant, where were you? Why weren't you in the Daf all these years? Okay. Farakway. You're going to get kicked out of Shir, David, in a second. All right, here we go. I was so excited that Elon's song was all the way at the end of the daf at 8:02 and we didn't have to sing it. Baruch Hashem. He wants to do it. You like the song?
Yeah, I love the song. Everybody loves the song.
It's a great song. The beginning too? Oh yeah, hello, hello, Yirata. Oh yeah, hello, hello, Yirata. You gotta play that again. Look at that. That's amazing. That's one of the best ones ever. Give Valder. All right, and we had enough fun. Yoira Shemoires Abriois, we have in the pasuk we say every day in Shema at least two times, three times. We're not going to go into this pasuk for now. What is Yoira Malkosh? We're going to learn that Yoira comes in the beginning of the season of Cheshvan, and Malkosh is at the end of the season. It's the type of rain called Malkosh. It's at the end of the season in Nisan. Yoyresh, Shemoyresh, Habriyos. Now, we're also going to learn that the word Yoyra can mean three different things. It could be a lashon of Yoyra to teach, Moira. It could be Rava to saturate, what's the word? Not a good word. Satiate. Or Yara, Yara, like to shoot in Hebrew. Yara, it's to destroy. So let's see it inside. Yoyra Shemoyres Habriyos, it teaches people, Tiagag, you say, take care of your roofs. I personally understand this. I live on the top floor. You can make it a little lower. I hear myself. So I have a lot of leaks in my house. Don't buy my house right now. No, that we used to have, and we fixed it up. But right now, I just kept on pushing it off. So every time it rains, there's like four corners of the house, it drips on my bed. She thinks it's not a big deal. A little drip in the middle of the night. Didn't kill anybody. It bothers my wife. I have no idea why. So I called up the guy last week. I'm like, you know, it's about Yaira time. We got to fix this roof. And he's like, yeah, I'll come. And of course, he didn't show up. Fine. But I understand it. When the rain comes, there's certain things you have to take care of, especially when you live in Eretz Yisrael. Shemayr is habris latiach gagasem. Literally, latiach gagasem. Get that roof done. Ulahachnes is perisayim. You have all that fruit outside sitting there. Get it indoors. Velasis kotzochem. Anything you need. I also have an indoor air conditioning system that I just put on my study. It doesn't belong outside. It belongs inside. And it's outside. It didn't fit in my room. So we're supposed to build something around it. Yeah, no, but we have like a plastic tablecloth on it. I'm not joking. La kotzochem. Dover acher shemeravis haoretz. It saturates, that's the word, saturates the ground. Umashke atahoim, it goes all the way down deep. So that's Rava. Shinemar tlomeo rave, the furrows, you're going to saturate. Nacheis gidudel, it'll give nachas, losha nachas to the people, to the gdudim. Bervivim timogigeno, and the showers will soften. Tzimchot tevarech, I'll have a blessing, the tzmach. Dova acher. And finally, what's the last pshat here? You can see it in the Gemara, but it's much cooler. Yore, yore. Dova acher. Yore, shiore ben nachas, ve'enoi, yore, bezav. That's not the pshat. Now we're going back to this pshat, to the green. That is a lashon of teaching. Rashi says, how do you teach? Talmidim ben nachas. Divrei chachomim ben nachas nishmoim. There's a beautiful Rabbeinu Gershom, if you want to see. In my Gemara, it's on this side. I saw in other Gemaras as well. It's on Amud Beis. You can look. I don't know where it is in your Gemara. And some it's on Amud Aleph, because it belongs in Amud Aleph. But on Hey Amud Beis, it says, Shiyari benachas, kemoi oise hoira lebanov benachas. When you're mechanic your children, if you want it to penetrate their heads, you do a benachas. Screaming doesn't work. As always, the Rabbeinu Gershom. Shiyari benachas ve'eino yorid bezaf. Doesn't come down angrily. Maybe the word yore means like lashon yara yiyara. It's shooting it down. It's destroying it. Now, what's very interesting is that if you look at the psukim over here, if you do everything correctly and you worship HaKadosh Baruch Hu, I'm going to give you the rain in its proper time. So what is Yoyre Malkosh? A good thing or a bad thing? It's a bracha. It's going to be a bracha. How in the world could you say that it's a klala? Rashi asked the question. And Rashi says something very interesting. We're not serious. Sometimes we want to exhaust all different questions. Any question you have, we're going to throw it out there. Let's just get this straight. Let's make sure we know what we're talking about. It's not a bomb question like, oh, maybe it's a klala. It's a derech ha-gemara. We're asking questions. We put in some things. So it's an insight into how gemara works. I'm telling you, it doesn't make any sense, this gemara. You're right. It doesn't. And if you want to push it into pshat, so there's another gemara that says, v'safta de-gonecha, it's a bad thing that you're going to have to take it. But these are all tchiyas, says Rashi. At the end of the day, we know the real pshat. This is the real pshat. But maybe you'll say, maybe you don't like what I'm telling you yoyra means. Maybe yoyra means the opposite of what you think. Maybe it means it's a klala. Why? I don't know. So I'm going to prove to you not. It ruins everything. The seeds, the trees. I learned it now from Malkosh. My Malkush Lebracha, Af Yair Lebracha. So perhaps, so just like Malkush is a Bracha, so too is Yair. Oh yeah, no, Malkush. Now why is Malkush a Bracha? Because when it comes, at the time that it comes in Nisan, doesn't really do anything. It doesn't destroy anything. It's a time when there's no fruit on the trees. Maybe the word Malkush comes from a lashon of destroying hard things. Shemapil, it's oh Malkush. We're going to see soon that lashon of it cut off the hardness it takes to care of hard things. It'll destroy the houses like a tornado, like a real bad storm. Umeshavers ha'ilanos, umalas ha'sakayin, and it'll bring locusts. So I was learning it yesterday, and I had a machshava, and I thought it was very interesting. You guys probably don't know about this. You probably heard about it. But if you live in the Midwest, like in Chicago and in a different place in the Midwest, there's an unbelievable creature. It's called a cicada. It comes out every 17 years, every 13 years. The thing is massive and it's ugly. It's scary looking. By the way, Shalom Aleichem, I missed you. So I have a picture of it. And they fly uncontrollably and they bump into you and they make a noise like you've never heard. It's literally 100 decibels. Look it up. It's crazy. For weeks, they go in circles. They come out every 13 years. And no, sometimes 17, sometimes 3, 7. They have different cycles. They can live underground. He knows what I'm talking about. They live underground for years. And finally, they come out after 17 years. It's a pillar of bria. Baruch Hashem, for that first, right? When they come out, it's a disaster. You don't want to be there. They hit you in the face. And they're screaming and yelling. Mamish, I'm not joking. They make this crazy sound. And they're okay, fine. Nishna, New York. In Iraq, Kodesh, New York, they don't exist. Look at this. Look at this thing. I mean, it's a creature like Kodesh Baruch Hu. Look at the size. This is on a human hand. It's a pretty big thing. And they get run over. And I was thinking to myself, maybe that's what the Gemara means. Because what else comes out of the ground? Locust comes out of the ground if you put a lot of rain. And then I'm looking at the word, sakain, cicada, maybe. I'm just throwing it out there. I don't know. Like what else? What else do you put water in and out comes an insect? Okay, tonara. Tamaloy mar yoyra. Ma yoyra lebracha, af magish lebracha. So, at the end of the day, it could go this way, go that way, but we say no. Yoyra. Ma yoyra lebracha, af magish lebracha. The Yair Guvim and all, but we're going in circles here. How do you know that Yair is a bracha for Malkush? Well, maybe Malkush is not a bracha for Yair. But at the end of the day, how do I know Yair is a bracha? The Chsiv, and we had this pasuk yesterday. Should be happy, but in Yoel. Back to the time when there was 7 years of famine. Remember, that's where Remeir learned that the entire month of Nisan is a month of Rishon, the month of Rishon, the entire month is a month of rain, and you should save a Saint Talmudah. Torah Banan, but you see in the positive, the word Yoira is a good thing. He gave them a bracha, not a bracha. It rained, and in 11 days, poof, all this wheat came out. Torah Banan. Yoira b'mar cheshvin u'malkosh b'nisan. So, Yoira u'malkosh, we say it every day in Shema, we have no idea what we're talking about. Maybe now, we'll have a little bit of understanding. I'm not saying we're going to understand it completely, but we know that Yoira is a type of rain, and Malkosh is a type of rain. And when does Yoira happen? In Cheshvan. Malkush happens? In Nisan. Atoy ben Yoira ben Mar Cheshvan, Malkush ben Nisan. Oyeinoy, Elo Yoira ben Tishrei, or Malkush ben Iyar. So, the Meroy Mesada was the Netziv. Just to explain a small explanation here in the Sugi, he says, the Gemara is asking, maybe, if you delay it by a month, it's still considered Beitoy. Yoira, Malkush. What's the lashon of the pasuk? Bitoy. Bitoy Yoyer Malkush. Perhaps 30 days later, still considered in its time. That's Gemara's question. Not stam. Oh, maybe it's in Kislev. Maybe it's in Chveis and Chanukah. Maybe it's in Purim. No. There's a reason to it. We'll push it off. Instead of Nisan, 1 month after Nisan is here. No. That's not its time. It's not within Itoy. Malkush. So again, the word Malkush could be one of four options, says the Gemara. Mal is a lashon of mila, to chop off their brazen, their harshness, their stubborn, whatever it is, their toughness. Omar, yeah. the Bay Rabbi Shmuel Tana Davar Shemim Mali Tvua Bekasher. It's a lashon to fill. This rain, this final rain, comes down in Nisan and it gives the oomph that the wheat needs. It fills it up. V'asisa Tana Davar Sheyored Al Hamelilois V'Alakashin. It three pshat. It hits. Not that it fills it up. It goes down and it gets the actual stalk and the tvua. Tana Rabbana. Same thing that we had before. Right? There's a freebie. We said it word for word before. Tanyidach. Yoyra happens in Cheshvan. Right after the Yom Tov, right after Sukkot, comes the Yoyra. Like, no, we're in Kislev already, right? I guess we didn't have a Yoyra yet. V'nisan, the Rimeh, not bad. So, Yoyre b'mar chesh v'magish v'nisan, the Rimeh. V'chacham v'moyrim, Yoyre b'kislev. No, you're wrong. It's a month later, say chachamim. Mar chacham, who these chachamim? Omar av chizda, Rabbi Yossi. This is Rabbi Yossi. Now, we can read it, and it can get a little confusing here. Let's show, we'll just read it. Let's see if anybody chavs is flying here, because it's a bunch of numbers. Ezi Revi Rishoyna Habakiro, the first one, Bishloshim Mar Cheshvin, the third of Cheshvin. Benin is Bishiva Boy, the seventh of Cheshvin. Avela, the last one, Bishiva Asar Boy, Divir Meir. Ryudaimir, Bishiva, Biyudzayim, Besim Shloisha. Ryudaimir, Biyudzayim, Besim Shloisha. So I'll show you what I try to do here. I hope that this helps a little bit. This is the calendar. If you understand this, it'll be very simple. There are five dates on this calendar. Gimel, Zayin, Yudzayin, Chav Gimel, Rish Chodesh. The first man, the Omar, uses the first three. The second man, the Omar, uses from the second one three. And the third man, the Omar, uses the final three. So, Rabbi Meir, who's in green, uses, I put a green star here, Gimel, Zayin, Yud Zayin, the first three. Rabbi Yehuda, who's the second one, blue stars, Zayin, Yud Zayin, Chav Gimel. These are the Revi Rishoyna. This is the first rain. The first rain has three rains in it. There's three rains. The first rain, the second rain, and the third rain. When are these rains, when is it supposed to happen? Gimel, Zayin, Yud Zayin. Zayin, Yud Zayin, Chav Gimel. Or the final three in purple, that's Rabbi Yossi right over here. He does Yud Zayin, Chav Gimel, Rish Chodesh. Okay, it's that simple. Now let's see inside again. Ezehi Revi Rishoyna, what is this first rain, which includes three rains to it? Habakira, the first one, Bishloisha b'marcheshvan. That's Gimel. This is going according to the Meir in green. Beninus, the middle one, Bishiva boy, seven of Cheshvan. Afela, the last one, Bishiva Asar boy, the 17th of. But they're all using, what's geshmak about this is, they're all using the same dates. There's no machloikis in the dates, thank goodness. That would be a mess. He says Gimel, he says Dalet, he says Zion, he says. No, they're all using the same within the same five dates. There's a machloikis three ways. You start with the first date, start with the second date, you start with the third date. Rabbi Yehuda Omer b'shiva ube yudzayin ube esrim u'shloisha. Rabbi Yehuda goes down one. He doesn't start as early as Rabbi Meir, he starts by the next one, Zayin. And then after Yudzayin comes Yudzayin, Chav Gimel. Rabbi Yossi Omer b'yudzayin ube esrim u'shloisha ube Rish Chodesh Kislev. He goes all the way to Rish Chodesh Kislev. One, two, three. Great. V'chein oyer Rabbi Yossi Omer ein ha'yichidim esanin. Rabbi Yossi would say, the Chassidim, Yechidim, says Rashi, are the Chassidim, those who do Lifnei Mishur Sadin. They fast. Now, you start fasting, right? In Eretz Yisrael, they used to fast. I remember there was a tkufa that there was no rain, and there's fasting and davening. I don't remember, since I moved there, I don't think it happened. But I remember when I was in America, they would say, oh, there's a big fast going on at the Kaisel. Yeah? You remember this stuff? Am I making this up? How long ago? Long time ago.
Maybe so often that, with this. Special tefillahs for rain.
The Israelis know how to create rain or something.
They say special
slichas. Special slichas, special this, right. The Hasidim would start fasting if there's no rain. Achigia Rish Chodesh Kislev. Who does that go according to? It goes according to Rabbi Yossi, who says that the Revi Rishoyna is Yudzayin Chav Gimel Rish Chodesh. Now, if you don't have any rain by this date down here, then you start fasting. But according to Rabbi Meir, shouldn't you start fasting by Yudzayin? Because his dates are Gimel, Zayin, Yuzayin. So they should start fasting here. No rain. The three dates of rain went and came, and There's no rain. Let's start fasting. So this goes according to Rabbi Yossi. Omar Rav Chisda, Halach Rabbi Yossi. The dates are Yudzayin, Chav Gimel, Rosh Chodesh. Now, Rashi is Gurus over here. Rabbi Yehuda. Now, it's very possible, you know, like even when I do the Sikkum, if there's no Rabbi Yehuda in the Sugya and it's Rabbi Yossi, I'll put a Reish Yud. I'm just throwing this out. So you can get confused sometimes when you're a printer or whatever it is between Rabbi Yossi and Rabbi Yehuda. It's Reish Yud. Rashi says, we're not going to Rabbi Yossi, we're going to Rabbi Yehuda. Amemir Masin Lod, Rav Chisda, Bahal Ishna. Amemir says Rav Chisda differently. You start, we had this, you say the same Talamater on the 3rd of Cheshvan, in the 7th, Rav Chisda, Halachak, Yerim Gamliel. Nothing to do with the three Revi'ahs, it has to do with when you start saying with the same Tal, according to Yerim Gamliel, the 7th of Cheshvan. Now, Kimana Azlo, how the Tanya Rav Shimon Gamliel, Oymer, Rav Shimon Gamliel, Oymer. Geshom Shiyardu B'Shiva, Shiva Yavim Zachazah, if it rained 7 days in a row, Atamayna Bem Revi'ah Rishayna Ushniyah, you could count it as the first rain and the second rain, and also Shniyah Ushlishas, the second and the third. Okay, we read it, Rishayna Shniyah Ushlishas. I'm telling you Pshat, the Pshat is the second and the third. Now, I'll show you in a second what this means. Kiman Kirib Yoisi, or Chizda Allah Kirib Yoisi. Check this out, very, very simple. I did it over here, you can see very clearly. If it rains 7 days straight from Yud Zayin, you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you bump in to the second rain. You do the same thing again, you cheat a little bit, you do 24, 20, you don't really start on the Chav Gimel, you start over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Bekitzer, you could get from the first rain to the second rain within 7 days. You could also get from the second rain to the third rain in 7 days. Here it is, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You could only do that according to Rabbi Yossi, because Rabbi Yossi says, Yudzayin, Chav Gimel, Rish Chodesh. But let's take anybody else, you take Rabbi Meir. So you get from the first rain, from Gimel to Zayin is only 4 days, you could get it. If it rains 7 days straight, you'll get it. But you're not going to get from Zayin to Yudzayin, which is a 10-day gap. So if you have 7 days of rain, you're not going to bridge the gap with a 10-day gap with 7 days of rain. It doesn't work. And it also doesn't work for Rabbi Yehuda. For Rabbi Yehuda. Rabbi Yehuda has that same 10-day gap. 7 days don't work. But 7 days does work for Rabbi Yossi. So Mela, this line over here. Gishamim shiyardu shiva yom zachazef. Rain, if it rains 7 days straight, atamayna ben revi'a rishonu shnir shlishis, you can bridge gaps. Kimak Rabbi Yossi. Amar Rav Chisda, Allah Rabbi Yossi. Says it again. Bishlam revi'a rishonu lishon. I understand why there are three rains. What's the significance of each rain? The first rain is, you start asking, right? You have a machlokes, we just had the machlokes. You start asking St. Talmater on the 3rd of Cheshvan or on the 7th of the Cheshvan, according to Rav Meir, you start on the 3rd. According to Rav Yehuda, you start on the 7th. Okay. Shlishish, Lisanois. Again, like we mentioned before, Chassidim would start fasting over here. According to review, they start fasting over here. We have to know when they should start fasting. There's no rain, it's a problem. Shniyah lamai. What do I need the second rain for, the middle guy? So it's interesting. We asked the question, we didn't know what to do with it. And the Gemara has a bunch of ideas. More than one. It could be either for Nedarim, what's the Lashon B'nei Adam? When a person says, I'm not going to eat chocolate until it rains. What does he mean? He means until the second rain. Rains. Rains, not rain. Rains, plural, whatever, that's Lashon B'nei Adam. Or, when it comes to olives, the second rain, that's a certain shear. We're going to see soon in Lekech Chopeya. Also, there's a takana that you can walk, take shortcuts through people's fields up until the rainy season. Because once it rains, you're ruining the field. You don't have to ask for shul. So you go like in Muncie, we go through the different houses to get to shul. Over there, it's with permission. But in the time of Chazal, you don't need to ask permission. Chacham gave you permission. That's until the Revi'a Shniyah. And finally, Biur Min Asada. Once it rains the second time, it ruins all the food. And therefore, the animals don't have food in the field. If the animals don't have food in the field, the animals at home, the dogs, the cats, don't have food. And therefore, you have to be Mevar. You have to burn all your Shemitah food. We're talking about a Shemitah year. Let's see it inside. Says the Gemara, Omer Ebzer Linadarim. The significance of the second reign of the Revi'a Rishayna is for Neder. Son, This not, it says in the Mishnah, Hanoyder Adag Shamim, if a person says, I won't do XYZ until it rains, or Misha Yerduk Shamim, or from the rainy season on, I'm going to start working out. What does it mean? Is it the first rain? Is it the second rain? The third rain? Achet Terid Revia Shnia. It really means the second of the first, the Revia, second Revia, second rain. We just turned to Vav and Beis, sponsored by Adam Vales, in memory of my mother, Galef Rathner. Abigail Gitabat, Pesach V'chave Rivka, sponsored anonymously, Zuchus V'shal Tamar Chaya, Batzar Tav Rufu Shlema B'Karoi. Rav Zvid Omar L'Zeisim. It's for olives. The significance of the second one is olives. It's not. It says in the Mishnah. Me'masik Aladam Mutar B'Lekit B'Shichu B'Pah. It's a beautiful thing. The Torah says we have to give to the poor. We give Meiser, we give different things. Meiserani. Not every year, fine. But if you have a crop, you have a field, there's a number of things you have to give for the anim. You have to give leket. Certain amount that falls out of your hands as you're collecting it stays for the anim. Shikha, whatever you forgot to take it, you didn't put it on the tractor, it goes for the anim. Peya, the corner of the field goes, matonis, matnis anim. Anim, go into your field. Now, you're looking at your field, you're looking at the videos, nobody shows up, nobody's coming. It's going to get spoiled. What should I do? Could I use it? No. Yes, you could. When? Even the wealthy could eat it. When? The guys that feel around, the feelers. When those guys are done, they didn't pick up on your little secret. You have something hidden under a bush somewhere. You go get it. Now, oilois, just to show you, this is just for illustrative purposes only. Pretend this is a normal grape. This is a damaged one. This is oilois. This is not very healthy. You give this, that's what you leave for the anim when it comes to grapes. When? Mishiyach anim bekerem. When they go in the vineyard, v'yavayu, and they come back again, they double up, they come, go, come. They don't pick up on this. They don't even want it. They're chashv anim. They take the real stuff. When they leave this, then you can go in there and grab it. V'zeisim, this is what we're looking for. When it comes to olives, when can you start taking olives? Mishateret Revia Shnia. Once the second rain comes in, you're good to go, you can take it. My Nemushis, let's just go back to that word, Nemushis, Amar Rabbi Yochanan, Sovei Da'azle HaTigra, the elderly that go with a cane, they walk really slow, they notice everything on the ground. If they didn't take it, you can go ahead and take it. Rish Lakish Omar, Lekoite Bosar Lekoite. This is a double picking. In other words, Rashi says, for instance, a father and a son go through the field and the father didn't pick up on it. The son didn't pick up on it. You could go and grab it. So this is a special halacha that you're permitted to take a shortcut through the fields, but don't ruin the other guy's field. When do you ruin it? When there's a lot of rain and you're going to create a whole mess, you're going to ruin his crop. He planted the seeds in the ground. You're going to walk through the seeds. And you're going to ruin the field. You're not allowed to. When does that happen? Don't worry about the first rain, a little drizzle. The second rain. Up until the second rain. This is, when you have to, you must. And this is confusing for me, for many others. The concept of be or perish on Shemitah. This year is a Shemitah year. So if you buy fruit from a Jewish farm, which we try to stay away from because most of the stores there, they sell either chutz la'aretz fruit or from Arabs. But if you buy from a Jewish farm and it's perish shmita and you don't eat the end of the cucumber, the peel of the cucumber, you have to take those cucumbers, you have to be viral, but whatever. That's not what we're talking about. We're talking about there's a certain period of time that the animals are not eating the fruit from the trees anymore. The cucumbers are not growing anymore. So once they're not growing, then you have to destroy the fruit that's in your house. You have the fruit in your house. You have a nice cucumber. You have to get rid of it. Cucumber is not such a great muscle. Well, fruit. The rice of fruit, let's say. You have to destroy it. So people are mafkir it, and then they coin again. But you have to destroy it. When? Listen now. You have wheat that grew on the seventh year. Right now. So when could you benefit from it and use it as firewood? Because once it rains, it starts destroying that produce. Now the animals don't even want it. The animals don't want it outside, then your animals inside don't get it, and therefore you have to destroy it. My time with the chsiv, look at the pasuk, v'levehem techa, v'lechai asher ba'aretzecha, the animal in your land, as long as the animals are eating in the field, and each food is different. You have the dates that the animals, the birds are eating off all the way till then, and you have the apples that they eat only up until then. Each thing is different. So you take a look what it is. You could feed it to your animal at home. What kind of animal are we talking about? I don't know. Maybe there's certain animals you're allowed to have. Because he said, dogs you're not allowed to. I get all these emails. You're not allowed to have a dog. Get rid of it immediately. Certain dog. And they're not talking about your children there, right? Not those babies. No, I mean... Now I'm going to get three emails for that too. And I saw the Kalele. No wonder he doesn't pray because he said he called him a baby. Okay. Now, it's very possible. This is all the Litzonis. You know, it's possible as long as the cats here in Eretz Yisrael are eating your garbage out of the garbage can, you don't have to do beer. It's not called Min HaSada. And that could also. What? They'll never be yours. Never be beer. Maybe. And that's right. And that's why cats are getting all these. The Haredim are very upset. The cats are getting more money than the Haredim. Right? But it could be they're doing it on purpose. They're trying to help the Haredim. I don't know. It's like.
Always.
I actually heard of a guy, you know, because the Haredim are always looking for the shtick. A guy went to get a cat ID. He said he's a cat. Yeah. Today in America, that would fly. You can say, it's what you decide you are. It's funny, like, I wanted to get money from my cousin, Leona Helmsley. My cousin, for like, related through the Pupkos. Yeah, I'm related to the Pupkos, believe it or not. So, yeah, she set aside $12 million for her dog. $12 million when she died. This dog got 12 million. What are you going to do? So, what about me? I'm Mishpacha. Garnished. Omar Rebbe Abo, my Loshen Revia. What's this Lashon Revia? Tough Lashon. It's a Lashon of Bia. Tashmish. Revea Sakarka. Kidrav Yehuda. Domar Rav Yehuda. Mitro Balodaru. This rain is like the husband of the ground. Shenemar. Ki. Kashe Yireid. Hageshen Vashelek. Menashumayim. Vishama Lo Yashuv. Ki. Everybody knows this possible. She gave birth. The ground gave birth. In other words, it has a husband. The rain is the zachar, and then and the makabel, the ground is the makabel, and she gives birth to tzmach. If you have this revere shayna, what good is it? Now I don't have to fast anymore. But how much? Well, a little drizzle? No. It has to be that it's absorbed in the ground, the full tefach. Shnia, what's the second one for? Kidei laguv ba pichoves. How much? That the dirt is so moist that I could go and seal a barrel with it. Omer av chizda gisham shoyadu kidei laguv ben pichoves ein bohem mishum va'atzak. The curse, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is going to stop. If you do all the Avodah Zarah, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is going to stop the rain. No, once you have that, there's no curse anymore. That means there's no curse. And this is interesting. What is V'Kodim V'Otzar? If you don't have Rashi, you don't know what's flying here. Kodim V'Otzar means before Zman Kriya Shema. Before we say in the morning, V'Otzar is a Shemayim. That means Kodim V'Otzar, right? If without Rashi, anybody would have understood this? I don't think so. Ein Bahem Mishum V'Otzar. Shom Shiyar D'Kodim V'Otzar. Ein Bahem Mishum V'Otzar. If it rained right before Zman Kriya Shema, there's no curse. That's not a curse. Oh my bayo, let's qualify this. Well, you say Kriya Shema in the morning, Kriya Shema in the evening. If it rained a little bit before the evening, that's great rain. If it rained in the morning before you got up, that's not good. That's still a curse. Why? I'll prove it to you. These clouds of the morning, they're worthless. The chsiv, Moesel lecha Ephraim, Moesel lecha Yehuda, v'chaz lechem kanan boiker. It's nothing. It's worthless. It's like the morning clouds. But I have a right against you. There's a saying. If you open up your door and you're smacked in the face with a bunch of rain, is that a curse or it's a bracha? It's a tremendous bracha. Why? Bar Chamra, you tell the donkey guy, Much sakach ugni. Fold up all your wheat that you're about to sell, your sacks full of wheat, go to sleep. You don't have any business. Your business is over. Why? There's so much rain. The wheat is so plentiful, the market just dropped. Go to sleep. In other words, rain in the morning when you open up the door, rain in the morning is a good thing. It might not be good for the Bar Chamra, but it's good for the world. There's a lot of produce. So the Gemara like Kasha, Adikadir Be'eva, Adikadir Be'anani. You have to differentiate. If there's very heavy clouds, Kadir Be'eva, then it's a Siman Bracha. Kadir Be'anani, it's Shvacha Maisis, no good. Omer Avyuda. Tov L'Shat Tevis, Armalta. Armalta is a widow, somebody who doesn't have a husband. If there's no rain in Tevis, it's great. Tevis doesn't have a husband, it's good. Ikad Army, Below the loy bairi tarbitze. So Rashi says here, beautiful. Bairi is a lotion of bur tarbitze. In other words, think about it. In those days, no pavement, no sidewalks. It rains. What did your shoes look like? I don't know. Nothing like we have today. You're not going to yeshiva. Nobody went. It's like a snow day. It's like a massive snow day. You're going to start. It'll take you hours to get there. 1 foot in takes a minute to get your foot out. It's all heavy mud. So prevents people from going to yeshiva. No rain in Tevis is good. Talmid Chacham, go learn. It's also like we said yesterday, the mud gets stuck to the crop. It's no good. But if it doesn't rain, it's great. So it's great. Minavalta means it's minuval, it's disgusting. A good heavy mud is beautiful for Tevis. It's going to be good crop. Look Asha. Oh, that's a mitra mikara. This is why he said that it's, when it's dry, it's perfect, is when it rained beforehand. Rained already, the ground got its nutrients, now let it be nice and dry, and we'll go to yeshiva. But if it didn't rain beforehand, now I want it to be minuval, I like the mud, I need the mud. It rained over here, didn't rain over there. It's not a klala. I prevented the rain. There's a curse. It rained over here. It's not going to rain over there. Even the rain part, even the place that it rained, is a curse. It's going to ruin the crop. If it's too much rain, it's a curse. If it's a right amount, even if it's one city and the other city doesn't have it, it's not a curse. You go there and buy over there. There's so much rain that it's called a mud. Let's travel to the rainy place. What does that mean? There's so much. It's too much. So I'm trying to Rashi. It might be this. I might be completely off. I thought it means something like this. That there's so much rain on the ground that a drop hits the water. Another drop pops out towards it. This drop that you see over here is reaching out to touch the drop that's coming towards it. They're both going to meet in the middle. That's this picture over here. You know, they say that why do the parents grab the chasen and kala when they walk down the chuppah? So they say it depends. If you're a litvish, is that the chasen shouldn't run. You shouldn't like trip over himself and run to the kala. And if you're chasidish, is that the chasen shouldn't run away. Zog the Gemara. The guys writing that email are busy writing the other one. Don't worry about them. They're not going to write two emails. By the way, Ben Yehuda says over here that in Pesachim it says, Koshim is an Osef Shel Adam, Kikriyas Yamsuf. And the same thing by Chasan and Kala. Kasha Zivugim Shalom Kikriyas Yamsuf. And that's the connection, the correlation between the rain and Chasan and Kala. And he says, that's a big zgula for a shidduch, if somebody needs a shidduch, to say Shiras Hayam Besimcha Gdoila. Okay. We have more to say, but we don't have enough time. Zog the Gemara. My mevarach. Amar Rav Yehuda. Amar Rav. Moedim anachnu loch. Hashem elokeinu akol tipo v'tipo shirat elanu. As ben Yehuda. Say moedim anachnu loch al Hashem. Because Eiyov said, Hashem, you give me such tzaras. I think perhaps you messed up my name a little bit. You forgot my name. What did Hashem tell him? Hashem said, every tipo, every drop of rain, I know where it's going. Because if two drops and there's too much, it's going to ruin the crop. I know where every drop of rain goes. So that's why we say, akol tipo v'tipo, says the Ben Yoyada. Shirat alonu, Rabbi Yochanan Mesayim Ba'achi, ilufinu melo shir kayom, shenu girinu kamen galov, v'sifsenu sheva v'chulu. Adal yazvunu rachamecho, Hashem, this is bad for Ashkenaz. V'lo yazvunu, b'roi, baruch, roi v'aydois. Roi v'aydois, most of the aydois. V'lo yikol aydois, why not call aydois? Omrova, eimo keil aydois, that's what we say. Kelai dies, a boy's eye, have a wonderful day.